Hey, what's up, everyone? Neo Scyther here, getting back to my WWE 2K16 career series, where it is the week of WrestleMania. Well, in this game, last week was the actual week of WrestleMania. You get the point. So, of course, we have our obligatory one-on-one with our rival, only this time it's actually happening on Raw. I would be surprised if it happens on SmackDown, too. And the authority goal of winning a match without reaching level 3 stamina. That's doable. Alright, so, with that, I'm surprised we've gone, almost an entire month without our ranking going up. Where are the rankings? Anyways. Oh, Bray Wyatt's actually the number 2 contender. I did not realize that. Over Roman Reigns. I may actually rank up past Roman Reigns if I can beat Bray Wyatt this month at WrestleMania. So with that, let's go ahead and get started with Monday Night Raw.
Hey, the bell hasn't even rung.
And three punches to the face. He's already got 100% momentum, and I am down to yellow health and level 2 stamina.
Neither man looks like they are remotely entertaining the idea of backing down. Oh, Bray Wyatt. Looking for the
really?
Shoulders up in time.
Well, really, Bray? Just
that
really?
Count, that's all that matters. What a brutal way to take someone off their feet.
So, as I try to regain my composure here against Bray, because this game does everything it can to screw me over. And
looking fresh right now, which is good. You gotta wonder how much longer that can last, though.
Look out below! Look out!
Okay, I'm just gonna get outside the ring and walk around now. So, I did a little thinking today, and I'm probably going to change a couple things about how I record. Well, not necessarily how, but when. So a lot of these, I'll record a couple videos at a time, just depending on my work schedule and such. A lot of the times, I'll record them on the day I post them. Hence why a lot of the times, the videos might not be up until late evening. Because I work in the morning, and then I just record the video when I get home from work. So like right now, it is about 4:30 Eastern time on the day this is going to be going up, which is Thursday, April 5th.
There's no quit in these guys, but
the change that may end up happening, the change that may end up happening is I am probably going to start recording these about a week in advance. And that's going to be kind of twofold. One, to get myself off my lazy butt. And what I mean by that is a lot of projects I do, I have a lot of projects I want to do, including other Let's Plays, other series for my website, or my YouTube channel. Updating my website on a regular basis. That was stupid of me.
And that's why he's such a great athlete, such an important.
That was even more stupid of me. And a lot of it is, I'll just get home from work and not really feel like doing much of anything other than recording this video, and that's about it. So my goal is that on my days off from work, I'll actually record the videos for the next week's, WWE videos. So like this week, I'm off Friday and Saturday, so I will probably use those days to record next week's WWE videos. The second reason for it is, other than getting myself off my butt to actually get stuff done, other than just sit around and do nothing.
He doesn't want to do this outside the ring.
Well, I don't blame him.
Okay.
Keep the action inside the ring. That's where you're going to win this thing.
Really?
How much damage did that?
I can make a joke about no selling, but So basically, that's the twofold there. One gets me off my butt and actually gets me. Try to get myself a little motivated to do stuff. The other is actually having more time to work on other projects. Which means that a lot of videos, I won't really be able to talk much about. I have left on the controller, but okay. I won't really be talking a lot about what's recently been happening in the WWE, my thoughts on it. Still have happened about a week in the past.
The chilling moves that Bray
at least some of it.
An opponent with, the worst of
that being
which I guess makes sense, is his finishing move. Sister Abigail is in the building.
Sister Abigail sounds like a really bad teen comedy. But I'm
the shoulders are down. Two.
That would have been the worst match I've had so far in this series. A two-star match.
Quick thinking to avoid that.
Anyways, as I was saying, sadly, that means for a lot of the time we won't be able to talk about recent WWE things, but on that note, I actually had a rare Tuesday night off of work last night, which means I got to see SmackDown live for the first time in I don't know how long, probably since the brand split. I don't think I've had Tuesday night off since the brand split. That being said, holy crap, Ty Dillinger and Shinsuke Nakamura on SmackDown. Provided they stay there after the shakeup next week. Still, though, two of my favorite NXT superstars on SmackDown. That is both awesome and it pisses me off. It's awesome because, again, Ty Dillinger and Shinsuke Nakamura are probably two of my favorite superstars on NXT, if not my number one and number two superstar on NXT. The part that pisses me off is that I normally work Tuesday nights.
Oh, out of nowhere. Look at this.
Which sadly means I won't be able to see them without either DVRing SmackDown or
he sees it.
Just catching him whenever it comes to the network. I can't remember when they put Raw and SmackDowns on network.
Whoa, look out. He's trying to turn this around. He's still going, Cole. What guts!
We're looking at complete domination here.
Attacking from the top.
You can practically feel the wear and tear that's been done throughout.
Oh, no! Oh, man! A big-time miss.
And here's a cover.
Yeah, I'm not even going to do a one count for when I miss a moonsault. That would be kind of embarrassing. Well, I guess not really, because it happens all the time.
Nice. Not going to win many matches with that move. King Bray Wyatt is chilling in every sense of the word. The look in his eyes and his slow, calculated walk to the ring lets you know he's waiting to unleash evil. That's a very unsettling feeling. Things are not looking very good right now.
Now, I will say it's kind of funny that Dillinger debuted against the new human jobbing machine, Kurt Hawkins. Though I will say that, again,
boy,
having rarely watched SmackDown at all since the brand split, or I guess more accurately since Hawkins came back, I don't know if it's been that bad, but it seems like whenever I read about Hawkins having a match, at least on SmackDown,
moves like that can upset
it's been Hawkins coming out of losing end. Granted, I need to watch more main event and superstars. Because I tend to like watching people on the mid card more, sometimes in the main eventers. Depends on the show.
Is he still even conscious?
So maybe Hawkins had some victories, I just haven't been paying attention. It just seems funny though that whenever I read anything about him, it's usually him losing, and I don't know how I knocked out the ref.
Trying to get under his opponent's skin with this one. Wow.
But still,
he's still down.
My only real complaint with the debut, Dillinger's debut, that is, not Hawkins, is when Hawkins was saying he's going to give, he's issuing an open challenge, he's going to give him to the count of 10.
Boy, he is really tired.
And after that is when you hear Dillinger's music. What they should have done, and some I saw this posted on a website I occasionally read for wrestling news. Somebody posted, it was either that or a YouTube video. And somebody made a comment, they should have had Hawkins start counting.
And he brings
like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, yeah, get to 9, and then instead of him saying 10, you hear Dillinger's music start up for 10, which I think that would have been awesome.
Unbelievable.
Nakamura's debut, kind of underwhelming.
He's looking at it again.
He came out at the end of what I thought was a Cena, Nikki segment. But apparently it was Miz and Maryse that dressed to look like Cena and Nikki, so Anyways, though, and they kind of spoiled it by having the whole violin player there. Because as soon as that started, it's like I knew, obviously, Nakamura's debuting, which is freaking awesome.
Oh, come on. That's enough. He's defenseless.
He looks intent on humiliating and injuring his opponent. The rivalry
he jumped me in the start of the match and punched my face in.
History continues to grow.
Yeah, WrestleMania, I'm going to poke you to death. Yeah. So yeah, I'm a little disappointed in that, and also the fact that his debut match was a dark match main event against Ziggler. So he actually didn't compete on SmackDown, but still, it's awesome having both Nakamura and Dillinger on SmackDown. Even if I can't watch it live every week. So with that, speaking of SmackDown, we got one-on-one with Bray Wyatt again. Winning my match with Green Body Health. Calling it right now, match begins, ref gets knocked out. Calling it now. So with that, let's go ahead and get started with SmackDown and see if I'm right.
Uh-oh, looks like these competitors want to settle their rivalry outside of the ring.
Oh man, look at them go! Fists are flying!
So, I'm pretty sure I've said before that I have a definitive end to the series. I know exactly what I want to do to end the series. I might get more into that at some point without completely spoiling things. But, there's no real way to do without spoiling things. But one thing I do plan to do at the very end is do like a final wrap-up video. And just give my overall thoughts on between the series itself, the game, the career mode.
This thing's over.
And one of my complaints is definitely going to be the game giving you an authority goal that is impossible to do. Like winning the match with Green Body Health, but thanks to the rivalry, it automatically starts you in yellow.
These superstars looking for a victory, looking to build momentum.
You're right about that. Momentum is so important in a match like this.
Two.
Hey, you did it last time. I'm doing it this time.
Three.
JBL, sorry
Seems
for your
like
hat.
These guys are letting out a lot of pent-up frustration tonight.
Michael, when it comes to the personal history of Bray Wyatt, you're right.
Four.
We practically know nothing. We know about Rowan and Harper being at his side at all times. And yes, Sister Abigail is always lurking. But Bray Wyatt is such a mystery. I just can't figure out if it's better for everyone that way or not.
What's he going to do here? What's he going to do here?
We're looking at complete domination here.
Wait, is he still conscious? Man, that looked bad. Oh, wait, nice reversal.
Going for the cover.
I'm going for the kick out. I don't know, I wouldn't look too disappointed there. I mean, should have known that was coming.
And he dodges that one.
King, we spoke about Bray Wyatt, and it's not every day a superstar enters WWE's ranks and almost nothing is known about their personal life. I'll throw something out there. I think it's safe to say Bray Wyatt has lived a life filled with macabre visions. He keeps us in the dark because he wants us close to where he rests.
Oh, Michael. You just gave me the chills. I think you're right, though. We don't know anything about Bray Wyatt's life beyond what he shows us, because that's what he wants. Bray Wyatt wants everything, even the buzzards, to be a complete mystery.
Three! Nobody controls the pace of a match quite like this guy. Now back to the ring.
Inside the ring again.
Yeah, and they should be. This is where the action needs to be.
Going for the big one. Well, it'll take a minor miracle to come back from this.
Will it be?
Well, there's your minor miracle.
There can only be one top dog here in the WWE, and a win here will go a long way in solidifying one of these guys' claims of being the best in the business.
Insert Roman Reigns Undertaker joke here.
The moves that Bray Wyatt has at his disposal are vicious. One is more severe than the next. Let's face it, his throw suplex, clotheslines, crossbody, the avalanche, and running senton can put anyone away. Oh, yeah. And
some guys have clotheslined him over the top.
That'll give you nightmares for months.
Yeah, it is what it is.
What a match!
Look how slow he is to recover here. That was some serious punishment.
Shining Wizard. Oh, man. You're never the same after one of those. And I think he's begging him to bring it.
Yeah, that's begging him to bring it. No.
A lot from the looks of it.
I mean, I'll give him some if he wants some, but.
Going for it all here. Oh, my gosh. Wow. Now, that's what you call a finisher. This might be it.
Hey, the shoulders are down.
So did he legitimately kick out, or did he use resiliency? He used resiliency. He used up his finisher.
And he lands a crushing neckbreaker.
He is just getting busted up.
And it's
I can never remember what command I've got set up to deliver the sling blade on demand.
Going for the cover. Good luck turning your head after that one.
Yeah, you have a stiff neck for weeks. He's pulling out all the stops.
I thought it was
tonight.
Either Ode or Tappe. I'll have to check my move list for the next match.
Ow, that hurt.
Oh, wait. Nice reversal.
This might be a rope break. If the game knows what a rope break is. Or not.
Submission.
He's actually not
the
quite
locked in.
By the ropes. You're not even facing him, you idiot. Oh, my God.
It's over. It's all over.
But the ref, first he comes around the wrong side of Bray. Then he's not even facing him to see if he's tapping out.
Here's your winner.
I like the game. I do.
Wow.
I have my complaints, though.
Was, ladies and gentlemen, that's the kind of win that makes you feel good about yourself. And that's it for this week of SmackDown. Good night, everybody.
I got the bottle cap. And now I'm banging the microphone and everything. I'm just batting a thousand here.
Welcome back to the show. This is my guest tonight.
I'm the only guest you have.
Let's talk about what happened out there tonight. Some would say you're showing a different side of yourself lately. Do you find that to be true?
Sometimes, to get what you want in the WWE, you have to be more aggressive, more ruthless. I can assure you, I'm the same me. I'm going to go out there every night and fight for the WWE Universe. The only difference is, I'm taking no prisoners. I'm going to make it to the top for my fans, and that's all there is to it.
There you have it. Back to you, Cole.
Yeah, there's just one little problem. I don't know if the game's going to address it or not. That is my tag team partner. Goody, I don't care if he can connect to the server. I actually tried to do an online match think it was yesterday, and there's nobody playing the game, or at least not what I tried to do. I didn't do just a one-on-one match. I went to the, whatever the online option is where you can choose different, like, match types to do to get bonus points. Like, I decided to do a triple threat, and nobody else was online, so. Anyways, next up we have our WrestleMania match, one-on-one with Bray Wyatt. Authority goal, winning my match after my opponent does his finisher. Okay. So with that, let's get going with WrestleMania.
This is a rivalry that will go down in WWE history. Does it come to an end tonight? We'll find out in this next match.
Can't wait to see this one.
He looks geared up and ready to go tonight.
You think you know me?
Both men enter this match with tidal waves of momentum, which set them on a collision course for this very moment. It's all or nothing, and these two men wouldn't have it any other way.
So, you're going to see we're going to have a minor glitch with this system right now, and that is that there is no crowd.
Vicious neck
outside of when we hit a decent move. So let me just run a couple things through here. So basically, I mean, this isn't the first time this glitch has happened. But essentially, before this match, I actually had to completely back out of the game because it started stuttering on Bray's entrance. So with that guy, I had to close down everything else I was running in the background, like Kaspersky, Razor Synapse, whatever was going on.
Man, that's what you call swinging.
And it restarted it back up.
And missing.
It's kind of weird that we have no normal crowd audio. I don't get that, but again, it's not the first time it's happened.
This guy can go toe-to-toe with anybody.
And again, the mind games are played.
So we'll see how things go.
Oh, it looks like he's in no man's land here. He needs to be able to put things back together here.
Michael, this is a
kind of underwhelming from the WrestleMania crowd, I'll tell you. I mean, I've heard better WrestleMania crowds.
And regroup. I'm sure this will not come as a surprise, but very, very little is known about the personal life of Bray Wyatt. We know he has his family members around him, Eric Rowan and Luke Harper. But beyond that, and his finishing move's name, Sister Abigail, named after his sister who passed away, Bray Wyatt's not someone I'd describe as an open book.
Oh, out of nowhere!
Say, that'll be another complaint I have, is that the game just has random issues here or there. I don't know what causes them. It drives me nuts sometimes.
He's going to take a chance here.
Yeah, I don't know if this is going to be worth it or not. Look at this hang time.
Incredible.
Make like a WrestleMania match having near pinfalls here.
And he breaks the cover, forcing the referee to stop the count.
Well, that's just not enough to get the job done. Bray Wyatt displaying some amazing fortitude here tonight.
Come on, wake up, crowd.
Brawl complete with a big stomp.
And these guys are throwing bombs. They're pulling out all the stops.
Looking to build momentum.
Oh, this guy's just too strong. The shoulder.
And it's up. He got the shoulder up.
He's pulling out all the stops tonight.
Folks, this is where superstars become immortals. A win at WrestleMania lives forever in the annals of sports entertainment.
Oh, look at the emotion. Not a lot of spring left in his step right now.
Wow, nice dodge.
And he fails to connect with anything that time.
Man, that was some miss, all right. Two. I can feel the breeze all the way over here.
And he dodges that one.
Wow, what offense. Well, we're on the move here.
Keep forgetting I have other counters to that besides just Enziguri.
Oh, man, you're never the same after one of those. Boy, he just got laid out.
No, not give him a WrestleMania moment.
Looking to go Skyborn.
Six.
No, hang on, get down.
Scaling the turnbuckles.
Seven.
Getting some air here.
Ow.
Two after sitting next to you.
You gotta be kidding me. No.
No.
We're not ending this match on a DQ.
Even in darkness, you can see the whites of people's eyes and the audience fixated on Bray Wyatt and frightened.
We're not ending this match on a DQ. I don't think so. Of course, for all I know, this is actually a no DQ match.
Davidson gets all of it.
Ouch, that had to hurt. They can end it here.
Right now.
Two.
Tremendous victory.
Now, something I think I was going to mention that I forgot about it or kind of neglected to is that since I had to restart and go back in, the overall card might seem a little different than when we looked at it when we first tried to start the match. Because all I did when I edited it is after the loading screen is where I cut off from the first video, and then I edited in this run through the match, if that makes any sense. So I'm curious how the main event went. Or the game actually put Sin Cara in the main event. Note that Brock Lesnar, Roman Reigns, and Daniel Bryan, which Brock Lesnar won. Poor Sin Cara was even on the card. Nope. Won the Royal Rumble, not even on the card. Poor guy. And sadly, it's probably going to do the same thing. My partnership with Cesaro came to an end. I wouldn't be surprised. No, still has him. Though I have no relationship with him right now. Still has Cesaro as my tag partner, so. Well, anyways, when we come back, we'll be going one-on-one with Triple H on Raw, possibly. Next pay-per-view is Extreme Rules. Authority goal, getting my opponent's leg out the red. And did the ranking change at all? The heck happened to Roman? Oh, Roman went up. Oh, I'm not even paying attention. So Roman is now rank 1. Number 1 contender, Daniel Bryan's 2, Rollins is 3. Alright, so that I think you guys for watching. I will see you next time.